Apple just dropped a ton of AI announcements here at WWDC 2024 that are coming to iOS 18, macOS Sequoia, iPadOS, etc. I'm going to bring you my 10 favorite announcements that they made here today. Let's start with the new iPad calculator. And hold on, don't swipe away, don't switch away. I know a calculator is not that exciting, but in this case, it really is. I mean, yes, the iPad finally has a built-in calculator that can do calculator things, but more importantly is the way you can use the calculator on the iPad with an Apple Pencil to write out math problems and equations and get answers in real time that will even match your handwriting. Take a look.
When I make a change, the results update live. And I can go beyond basic math with all of the same functions from the scientific calculator. Math Notes supports variables, so I've declared a few here, and there's an expression below, which uses these variables to help me calculate the height.
All right, next, let's talk about iPhone mirroring. On your Mac in macOS Sequoia, you'll be able to pull up your iPhone's display, reference it, and even interact with it right from your Mac, even if your iPhone is in another room. You just need to be on the same Wi-Fi network. So in other words, you can have your phone on a charger and access your apps, notifications, and even drag files from your Mac over to your iPhone. So if you need to make a post on Instagram, you pull up Instagram on your iPhone, drag the photos from your Photos app over to the iPhone window and make your post without ever touching your iPhone.
We're bringing iPhone notifications to Mac. They appear alongside my Mac notifications, and I can even interact with them when I don't have my iPhone handy. Here's one from Duolingo. What's neat is when I click on it, bam, I'm taken right into the Duolingo app on my iPhone.
Okay, next, let's talk about the all new Siri. I think this one is major. This is something that a lot of people, I see it in the comments all the time. I hear it from my friends, I hear it from my family. What is up with Siri and its lack of understanding what I want it to do? Apple made huge strides today in addressing that, not only bringing Siri up to probably where we wanted it to be, but even beyond. Siri gets a new enhanced voice, but also gets richer understanding as well. So you can just talk to it naturally rather than talking to it in that Siri way of talking. I think if anyone's used Siri for any amount of time, you know what I mean. Right off the bat, not only can you talk to Siri like before, but you can type to Siri by double tapping the bar at the bottom of your iPhone's display. So if you're in situations where you can't just speak out loud freely, Siri's there to chat with you in text now. Siri also gets on-screen awareness. So if a friend sends you an address and a text message, you can just ask Siri to add it to that person's contact card. Apple is also giving Siri personal context, which means Siri can use the information on your device to help you. For example, if you needed to grab your license plate number, it can reference the photos in your Photos app, find your license, pull the license plate number off of it, and even insert it into a form for you. Or maybe you're trying to remember the show a friend of yours recommended to you a couple of weeks ago, but don't remember if it was in a text message, an email, or if you added it to somewhere in your Notes app. Just ask Siri, it'll find it for you and present it to you. Lastly, Siri is able to take actions for you in and across apps. You know, that thing the Rabbit R1 was supposed to do for you, but crashed and burned miserably. Siri can do that. So with the new Siri, you can ask it to send an email that you drafted to Bill and Anna, and it'll know which email you mean and will send it for you right away. Or in Photos, ask Siri to make a photo more vibrant and then add it to your recipe note for how to make a birthday cake, and it'll do both actions in two different apps, again, without you needing to make a manual switch yourself. All right, next, Genmoji. Frickin' Genmoji. We've got emojis, memojis, and emojis. Now we've got the Genmoji. And these might be the coolest emoji Apple has ever come up with. Apple is gonna allow you to create custom emoji on the fly. And you can do this right in your keyboard. Just type in a description of what you want to see, and Apple Intelligence will, again, on the fly, generate it for you. You'll see a preview of what it made, and then you can modify your text or just to slightly change and update the emoji that was generated until you get exactly what you want. You can even pick someone from your photo library, a literal person, and have it generate a Genmoji of that person in whatever kind of scene you can think of describing them to put them in. When you send the Genmoji, it'll actually send in line with your text, the same way your regular other emojis do. Obviously, Genmoji is not an important feature. It's not something that's going to change our lives, but it certainly is a super fun feature that I think a lot of people are going to have a lot of fun with.
Just provide a description and you'll see your Genmoji appear right before your eyes, along with more options to choose from. This is great in those times when you're updating a friend about your relaxing weekend, getting the group chat excited about brunch, or complaining about the rowdy squirrel right outside your window.
All right, next, there is Apple's new Image Playground. Apple Intelligence can also make images that have nothing to do with emoji. In the Image Playground, you can create brand new images from scratch just based on a text description that you come up with, people and scenes from images in your photos library, or even suggested concepts built into the app. To start, there are three image styles: animation, sketch, and illustration. So what's interesting about that is Apple is obviously not going the Midjourney route of trying to create photorealistic images that can trick people into thinking that they are actually real photos of real people. These all look like they're very obviously cartoonish or hand-drawn.
It's like themes, costumes, accessories, places, and more. In a few seconds, you'll see Apple Intelligence creates a preview of what your image could look like. A moment later, you'll see more previews you can swipe through. This all happens on device, so you have the freedom to experiment and create as many images as you want.
Apple Intelligence can also take care of writing text for you with the new writing tools. So not only can it proofread your writing, but it can change the sound of your writing. It changes your intent. So for example, maybe you write something out, but you want it to sound a little more professional. Or you were a little drawn out and you want to make it more concise. Or maybe sound a little more friendly. Maybe that's a challenge for you. Apple Intelligence is here to make your writing sound the way you need them to when you can't get it there yourself. Now, what's cool is these tools are available system-wide. So in other words, you don't need to be in the Messages app or the Mail app specifically, or in Pages or anything. This is available in any app where you're writing text. And when you need even more help, Apple has actually built ChatGPT into the operating systems. It's all baked in at a system level. So maybe you don't need help revising your text, and instead you need help just getting started with your first draft. You can send your idea to ChatGPT, and Apple will ask you and confirm, do you want to send this to ChatGPT for processing? So you're always in control of your data, never just gets sent over for you. And of course, since it's built into the operating system, that means you do not need to go to the ChatGPT website. You do not need to go to the ChatGPT app. This is all accessible from wherever you're writing text. The other thing you can do is send images or documents to ChatGPT and ask ChatGPT about them. So this lets you compose original text and even illustrations from scratch when writing, and this is all for free, again, built in. You don't even need to create a ChatGPT account. Now, if you do have a ChatGPT account, a paid ChatGPT account even, you can sign in and use the paid features that you would access on a ChatGPT website, again, directly baked in to the new operating systems. Next, Apple Intelligence is a pro at summarizing. So I'm sure we've all gotten those super long, drawn out emails where you just have a wall of text. You can ask Apple Intelligence to summarize it for you, and it'll put that summary right at the top. So you can read that and see if there's anything you need to kind of dive into more to reference. Or what about web pages? You go to a super long article, a news article that you want to read. Maybe you don't know if you want to read the whole article. You can get a nice summary in Safari and then make your decision from there. Or you know those email previews you have in the Mail app where it shows you the first few lines of each email in your inbox? You can have Apple Intelligence replace those first few lines of the email with a summary instead. So you can get a summary of every email before you click on it. And speaking of email, another new feature is Smart Replies. And this one is crazy. So if someone sends you an email that has questions you need to answer, I think the example Apple gave was some sort of invitation. So are you able to make it? Yes or no? What time will you be there? And are you driving or taking an Uber? Apple Intelligence will notice the questions that are asked of you and then present you with these multiple choice buttons. So you just tap on the answers to the questions that were asked, and then it'll take the answers you gave and generate a reply to the email that was sent to you. And of course, you can always modify it and edit it to your liking, but it'll take care of all that heavy lifting for you.
When you need to RSVP to an event, you will now see suggestions for your response based on the email. If you say you'll be there, Mail identifies questions you were asked in the invite and offers intelligent selections so you can quickly choose your responses. Your drafted response incorporates your answers. So with just a few taps, you're ready to send it off with all the right details.
Then there's a new cleanup tool in Photos. So we've all seen this before. You have distractions in your photo. Maybe you take a great photo, but there's like a piece of trash on the floor behind you, or a person who is a piece of trash in the background. Either way, you want to get rid of these things in your photos. And sometimes it's, if you're not a pro at Photoshop, it might be a challenge to do this. We've seen other companies do this. It's available in Google Photos. There's a lot of third-party apps that do this. Now it's just built right into your Photos app, so you don't need to download anything else to remove things from photos that are distractions or that you just don't want to be there. These were my 10 favorite features that Apple announced today using Apple Intelligence. There's so much more. They sped through the keynote. I feel like we're going to be diving in and learning more throughout the next week or so. So I'll bring you even more hidden features. But for now, let me know what your favorites were in the comments, and I'll meet you there for further discussion. Thanks for watching. As always, guys, I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I will catch you in the next video.